The G-32's cargo bay was nearing full capacity. Human workers in blue boiler suits hurried back and forth across its wide expanse. The ship's big rear doors opened onto the snow-peaked mountains of Vinsk. Despite the low temperature, sweat clung to the team's foreheads as they wheeled in crates and tethered them to long racks. Armed security guards in padded red uniforms served both to protect the merchandise and ensure the Zalnex Corporation storage guidelines were complied with. Up on the highest gantry, Lorena was getting little work done. The rosy-cheeked Welshwoman was preoccupied by her co-worker, Magnus, breaking into a crate.
"What do you think you're doing?" she said. "We're here to bring this Gemini stuff on board, not product test it."
Magnus was barely listening as he prized off the lid.
"True," he said, "but we work hard. The odd freebie won't kill Zalnex."
Lorena sniffed at the bottles of Gemini handwash tightly packed inside.
"No," she said, "but Zalnex might kill you."
Magnus fished out a bottle. On its front label was the zodiac sign for Gemini, which resembled the Roman numeral for two. He read the label's slogan for Lorena's benefit.
"Kill every virus, learn every language. Come on, Lorena. Surely you must be curious."
Lorena folded her arms.
"I'm really not. I never go anywhere foreign. Just back and forth between here and Earth."
Magnus ran a hand through his spiky red hair, bemused.
"Yeah, but wouldn't you even want to speak Vinsken so you could understand the locals here?"
Lorena shrugged.
"Why bother? They speak English."
Magnus sighed, rolled his eyes, and resealed the crate. The TARDIS whirled through the turbulence of the time vortex. On the outside, it was a blue police box, seemingly tossed around at the whim of the storm. On the inside, it was an astonishingly cavernous den, full of imposing girders, walkways, stairs, and gadgetry simultaneously retro and futuristic. Amy Pond appeared at the top of the staircase, sleepily pulling her long red hair from the neck of her stripy jumper. As the TARDIS rocked to and fro, she gripped the banister with both hands and carefully descended the steps. She loved watching the Doctor pilot his wonderfully impossible ship, darting around the central console, flicking switches as the glowing time rotor moved up and down above it. She half expected him to stick his tongue out of the side of his mouth in childlike concentration.
"Morning," she said as she joined the Doctor. "Or is it morning? I lose track."
The Doctor flashed her a smirk, then returned his attention to the controls.
We'll arrive one morning in the year 2112, by which time your lot have mastered space travel and are waist-deep in interplanetary trade. I'm aiming to land in the factory where Gemini antiviral handwash is made. This stuff gives you an incredibly fast crash course in all languages, virtually instant.
Sounds mad, Amy said. How does it work?
No idea. Just wanted to drop by and salute the good people at Zalnex. Perhaps I can help them test it. There are bound to be a few bugs.
Up on the cargo bay's highest gantry, Lorena watched Magnus squirting some Gemini onto his palms. The pair's colleague, Ramirez, slowly rose from a gap in the walkway beside them. A floating elevator platform was carrying the large Mexican, plus five crates of Gemini, up to their level. Magnus winked at Lorena and called over to Ramirez.
"Watch it! Do you want to try some?"
Ramirez's expression was typically unreadable as he set about shifting the crates from the platform.
"What is it?" he asked.
Within seconds of Magnus's explanation, Ramirez solemnly offered up his palms. Lorena shook her head and secured another crate. Suddenly, she froze as the two men cried out in pain. They staggered from one side of the walkway to the other, holding their heads. Their pupils expanded, eclipsing the iris, then almost all of the whites of their eyes. Lorena grimaced as the veins stood up on their faces and arms.
"Guys," she said, What's happening? The men stared at her, eerily eager, their hands taut like claws. Lorena didn't hear the sound of ancient grinding engines which heralded the arrival of the TARDIS. She was already screaming. Magnus and Ramirez reached out for her, roaring the same phrase over and over.
Listen to me! Listen to me! Listen to me!
Doctor Who, The Gemini Contagion, by Jason Arnopp, read by Meera Syal. Inside the TARDIS, the time rotor had come to rest, signalling the box's arrival on Vinsk. I once thought about learning French, Amy said as they headed for the doors, then decided not to bother. The doctor pulled a face. Why, that's a corker of a language, the sheer elegance of it. Amy shrugged. Just thought I'd never leave Ledworth. The doctor pulled an amused face. How very wrong you were. Amy grabbed the TARDIS door handle, then hesitated as a thought struck her. Your people, did they have their own language, or were they more like, you know, Belgians? The doctor gently laughed, but the smile didn't reach his eyes. As Amy opened the door, she resolved not to refer to the doctor's race so flippantly again. Emerging from the TARDIS, Amy was startled by the sound of men yelling and a woman screaming. At the opposite end of the gantry on which they had landed, a terrified woman backed away from two men, one tall and bulky, the other short, with red, spiky hair. Both men were shaking violently. They alternated between clutching their temples as if their heads were about to explode and lashing their arms around like enraged apes. They repeatedly roared the same phrase, "Listen to me! Listen to me! Listen."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.